we can rise to the occasion, we can build this nation moving forward. All that we need, visionary leadership, people who love their people, people who love the citizens, people who love the country, and then we can rise, we can fly again.
Hope Restoration Ministries, restoring hope to our world. Welcome to our broadcast. Enjoy.
Talking to you this morning under the topic, getting along with others. You know that we are closing the series of Uniting Families. So it's a final Sunday where we are closing this series. That is my topic this morning. Now, Bamba, all human beings are unique and wonderfully made by God. Don't ever forget that. All human beings are unique and wonderfully made by God. And getting along with them requires an understanding and grace. Did you hear what I said, Pastor Ron? Now, this goes to our families. If we have to get along with them, we need to have understanding and grace. The big question here is, how do you get along with others? Sengibuza wena. How do you get along with others? Are you quick to respond to others' needs? Or are you a person who minds your own business? It's a question. Do you put yourself in someone else's place? Or do you put them in their place? Do you know those type of people? They say, I will put you in your place. And because that is how they relate with people. How you relate to others will determine how far you go in life. Did you hear Basel 1? You need to understand life is about relationships. But there are four people that I want to address this morning before we read the scripture. Because it's in a four group of people here this morning. The first one, you know that you upset people, but you don't care. And number two, the other group, you upset people, but you are not aware of it. But you upset people. And there's a third group of people. You are aware that you upset people, but you don't understand why. And there's a final group. You have been upset by people and you have made a decision not to relate anymore. It's another group of people. Now, while you are searching yourself, it is very important for you to understand that life is about relationships. Relationship with God and relationship with others. You cannot live life alone. Now, these relationships can be good or bad, healthy or unhealthy. But they play a vital role in our lives. You are who you are today because of those good relationships and the bad relationships. The people that God brought in your family, bad as they are, they were there to shape you, to make you a better person. Are you with me? You're not going to cancel them today just because they are bad. Joseph, he became, you know, the prime minister because of the bad relationship that he had with his own brothers. Those bad relationships, they actually positioned him into his destiny. So bad or good, those relationships, they are good and very important for you. Bamba, bamba, our success, fulfillment, and happiness depend upon our ability to relate effectively with others. Relationship or relating to people also requires a skill, Bazalwan. And I am here this morning as we close this session. We need these things so that we can build ourselves, we can build our families, we can build our businesses to be successful. For your business to be successful, it goes back to how you relate with people. For your marriage to be successful, it goes back, how do you relate? Your family, the church to be successful, it goes back to those simple principles. How do you relate with other people? You cannot be a pastor and relate very rough with other people and tomorrow you complain. So it's more about relationships. We need to learn to relate with others because it is very essential. But let's look at what the scripture says. I mean, we look at Jesus, powerful as he was. Listen to what the book of Philippians says, and then I'll give you some few points after that. Philippians chapter 2. Bono verse 3, utinu verse 3. Listen, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourself. Not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interest of others. Isn't that amazing, Bazelon? And then verse 5, Liti, in your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who being in very nature God, he was God, but he did not consider equality with God something to be used, you know, to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant. Can you see what I see here? He took the nature. Nobody forced him, you know, with this nature. The Bible says, being God, he decided to take the nature. It was a choice, a free will choice. He took the nature of a servant. Are you with me? A nature of a servant. Being made in human likeness. This was God, but he took a nature of a servant. Now, when you read the same scripture with the Message translation, listen to what verse 3 says. Oh, verse 3, little, don't push your way to the front. Don't sweet talk your way to the top. Put yourself aside and help others get ahead. Don't be obsessed with getting your own advantage. Forget yourselves long enough to lend a helping hand. Let me tell you, I want to ask you to get a ngale attitude. I'm here in this marriage. I just want to push my wife. I want to push my husband. I'm in this relationship. I just want to, you know, uplift the person next to me. I want to cultivate. I want to make sure the person that is next to me, they become better. You know, they flourish. If we can come up with this session, with this type of an attitude in the church to say, you know what, I want to see other people coming right. I want to see other people being elevated. If we can do this as ministers to say, I want to better the lives of people so that you don't just, you know, make sure that everything revolves around you. My problem, and I'm saying this with humility, we're supposed to be far away as the body of Christ, especially the black church. The problem is that we are so selfish. Everything must revolve around me. For 25 years, imali yanikelwe ebandleni kodwa sahleze etendeni. Iyaphi mfundisi imali? Iyaphi? But things are just revolving around ourselves. By now, as an African nation, we're supposed to be far away. This thing goes even into the politics. By few nyana uyababona abaphumelela ukuthi abubani ungababala nanku ithenda lapha ithenda lapha ithenda lapha abantwana abana mabazari isikolo ziyabhethe isikolo azina sports facilities and all that. It is only few people who are succeeding in our country. And if God can help us, singayicabangeli thina. You are not a leader. We have not voted for you so that you can take care of yourself. We are voting for you so that you can take care of God's people, better the community, better the lives of the people, so that the life of black people can flourish. You are a leader, but you are saying you are holding a Department of Education. Go to Ingane Zakho, they can't even study kule sikolo kuso or principal kuso. Because you have not even built a sports facility. All that I'm saying, Bazalwane, we must not be selfish. Think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. He had equal status with God, but didn't think so much of himself that he had to cling to the advantages of that status, no matter what. Bazalwane, when you get the position, you get the status. But Jesus said, it was not about me. I will never take advantage of this situation. I am here to better the lives of the people. If we can have that type of an attitude to say, God has blessed me so that I can bless those around me. God has empowered me so that I can better the lives of these people around me. We're going to have better families, better communities, better country, better nation. Ninamba ndabengosi. Kodwa umsebenzi wami ulula bazalwane. I wanted just to talk about this thing. How do you get along with others while you have a different gifting, while you have a different anointing, while you are unique wena as a person? How do you get along with others? Here's the first point. Are you ready? Number one, how do you get along? Start by getting along with yourself. Did you hear what I said? Start by getting along with yourself. If you don't get along with yourself, you won't get along with others. Getting along with yourself includes, you know, self-awareness and self-forgiveness. Why? You must actually forgive yourself, because hurt people, you know, hurt others. It is very important, but it is more important, you know, to get along with yourself. You know, the scripture says in Matthew 22, verse 39, love your neighbor as yourself. You see, you cannot give what you don't have. Before you can love somebody, you must learn to appreciate yourself. You must learn to love yourself. That's why the Bible says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. And how should you love your neighbor? Look at how you love yourself first. Start by loving yourself. Appreciate yourself. Make sure that you are whole. Make sure that you are well, so that when you interact with other people, and then you also bring a meaningful, you know, conversation, because wena uright. Inkinga eyabantu nasemshadweni umuntu ungena emshadweni ulimele. Awukakapholi, you are not whole, and you are stepping into marriage, you expect somebody else to heal you. Ungena umshado, umshado uzangilungela. Lalela, uma ungakapholi, uletha izinhlungu, the pain emshadweni. When you speak, you know, amazwi alimazayo ngoba awuphilanga. Umshado is like two eggs, bazalwane. Two whole eggs. That you put them together, they produce an omelette. You don't take half eggs. As you get married as 100% person, whole. Uphelele. Ushada nomuntu ophelele. Lento ukuthi 50-50, ubani ofuna ukushada umuntu half. Weze emshadweni uhalf, lenye half uyishephi. And that is why I'm sad to imagine. Ilona law is like, now you must fill the empty container. Ngoba lo munyu zene container empty. Fill me, fill me. Na lo hlezi ngapha, ntlatse, ntlatse. Na lo ngapha, nitatisi, nitatisi na mina. And then na lo, mphe, mphe. And now you end up working so hard to fill someone's container. Kanti ngabe umuntu uza uphelele. You know, you are complete, you are whole, you have done your homework, you are together. Usata, hayi ngoba uyashoda. You don't get married because you want to get something, you get married because you want to give something. Start by getting along with yourself. Ziqala uyithande, uyihloniphe. Before others can respect you. And when you are whole, it's very simple for you to contribute into something. But uma ungaphelelanga, uma ukhuluma nje, uyezwa ukuthi uyashoda lona. Kunento eshodayo. Ushada nje usase head nge boyfriend yakuqala. No, vela amadoda njalo. How? So ungena emshadweni wena, you're looking at this man ukuthi inja. You are saying, hayi bazalwane. Be well. Mako uphole mtakabantu. Look at the person and just be healed. Praise the name of Jesus. Come on, give God praise. Somebody put it in a beautiful way. Uti, when a man becomes his own best friend, life is easier. Become your best own friend. And then number two, how to get along with others. Develop personal warmth. Develop personal warmth. I'm saying here, you need to loosen up and make people to be at ease. Don't intimidate people with your gifting, your anointing, your success. Do you know those type of people? Umangena nje ufanele ufile ukuthi sengkhona. Yeah, here comes Reverend Apostle, founder of Hope Restoration. Mangifika kufanele ukuthula umsindo. Event kuthule ukuthi cwa. Hayi bazalwane. You will lose friends when you relate like that. Are you with me? You will lose friends. Loosen up. Develop personal warmth. The Bible says he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant. You know, you must be a servant. You know, be warm. Be warm. One person says, wherever you go, no matter what the weather, always bring your own sunshine. Young Tola, bring your own sunshine. I always have a problem with this, and I give my family a problem because I'm that type of a person. Mina ngivele ngena ku lift nje, mangena ku lift nje, ngingena nje ku lift. And then angithi everybody ungena ku lift uyapress ubheka phezulu. I don't know why people they do that. You have press, you know, uyazi ukuthi uyoma kuphi. But they bangena ku lift babheka phezulu. Not ngoma table, mangena ku lift. Hello everybody. And people they look at me as if I said hello. Are you okay? And my family go, ah, don't do that. I said, no, I just want to find out. How are you? How was your day? How is your day treating you so far, ma'am? And people say, no, thank you for asking. Okay. But what I'm saying, you must be that type of a person. Bring the sunshine. Bring your own weather in the way. And the good one. Magesi emphasize, bring the good weather. Because remember, there's a winter, there's a windy weather. Don't bring your storm. When abantu bamnandi makungena wena, everybody now so umuntu ulethe yakhe weather. Do you know those type of people? Look at the person next to you and say, I hope you are not that one. La ungena khona abantu basala kunjani. You know those uncles? Mama funerals makungafika yena. We don't even want them to be in a program because how can they go programming? We are in urahadi. Rahadi, mama. Rahadi. How can fit rahadi? Matad. And now we ask to your Moshe. Hey, you must never. And you want to send those people to go and ask for lobola and then for your children. You figure more shelap. And then number three, not only that, it is very important not just to bring your warmth, but it is very important to value others above yourself. Value others above yourself. Now be interested in others. Their pursuit, their work, their homes and families. Rejoice and weep with those who mourn. Uthi Jesu, do nothing out of selfish ambition. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves. Very important, bazalwane. I think it was John Maxwell who said, people, they don't care how much you know until they know how much you what, bazalwane? You care. People, they want to know how much you care. You understand? Sometimes we come in, want to intimidate people, you know, education here too, and all that and that. There is nothing wrong. There is nothing wrong, you know, doing that. But goodness, cut where you need to put your education aside and then come to the level where you relate with people. You understand? That is why you parents, you must learn to teach your children, you know, to value the grandmothers in those rural areas. No, from this is lunga kulu. No, masibo vagasha basakwazi no communicator. No, grandmother. Hello, granny. Conversation in pelil. From there, may I have water? May I have that? And that they cannot even relate. No, gogo. You understand? Let's teach our people to say, people, they are not only at Johannesburg. They are not only in the city place. They must be able to communicate nabo gogo. Teach them. You come down to the level. Communicate now, but they must never take advantage of you. There are places where you need to put your DR next to your name. I am Dr. So-and-so. Because Jesus was, you know, he used a different language when he was speaking to ordinary people. But he was speaking to the Pharisees. He also used a different language because they were at this level. Ama relationships ngesikhathi afuna nje lokho. Kunesikhathi uyabona laba bakunyatsa la.
Yabona uyahlwa all okay laba ke bafuna ke bese ngithi I am Dr. Soren so I've got a PhD. Awuvele ukhiphe nje mntana muthi by the way ngine PhD. Manje ke thina ke ngoba sina ama PhD. Uma manje bangifuna nami babone ukuthi nami ngikhona phela ngiya exister. Ngithi I am a founder of Hope Restoration Ministries. Hallelujah. A founder of Devoted Citizen, a People Matter Foundation. Praise the name. I also own a company, Champions Maker. You must know where to use that. Ngizwile bantu bami. Ngoba phela kufanelanga manje bese ube iskepsele kuyo yonke indawo. Kunezinye indawo ongavele nje uvele noma kanjani. Value others above yourself. That is the main point here. You understand? Don't get into a place and then be the person, but value others because people are important ngokuhlukana kwabo. Niyangizwa bantu benkosi. Number four, realize that what you give is what you get. Are you with me? What you give is what you give. What you get. What you sow is what you will reap. You know, smile and people will smile at you. You don't get something unganikelanga lutho. So if you want people to be kind to you, and then you must also be kind to them. Number five, don't be unreasonable in your expectations of people. I need to take some time here. People are not perfect. Don't be too eager to get the credit due you. Do your best and be patient. Are you with me? The most important thing that I want you to grab here, look at Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. It says, in everything, treat people the same way you want them to treat you. That is very important. But the key word here, the key word, is that don't seek all qualities in one individual. Don't seek all qualities in one individual. It is known, Gamatebula, that I'm a good husband. It is known. I'm a good husband. You know, I provide. I don't even have to mention ezinyizinto. But you cannot define ubu husband bami ngoba ngingafuna ukwashizitsha. Angizwashizitsha kamathebula. Allow me to help people here. Because this we expect all qualities from one person. Ukuthi he must be, for him to be a good husband, ufane awashe izitsha, ufane apheke, you know, ayenze lo. But you look at this man wakes up in the morning, he cleans your car. Before you even go out, he warms your car. He makes sure ukuthi before elala, indlo ilokhiwe, the grass is looking well, everything is paid, you are protected. Ubuye endlini, how was your day, honey? Are you okay? He welcomes you with a kiss and all that and that. When uzom describe ngokuwashe izitsha ukuthi ubaba wala ekhaya akusuka ubaba ngoba akawasha izitsha. Udlala ngomshado wena. Maka ubheka lezi zinto lo baba zenzayo. Maka ubheka lo msebenza wenzayo and appreciate. Don't expect all the qualities from one man. Yes, you visited a man somewhere who is a good cook. That's good for him. That is good, but not this one. Mina ngikwazi ukupheka zangenza imali since ukuba uchef. Ngiyangithola empilweni yami bengiloku ngishumayela. Hayi, ngisiza abanye mama la, ngisiza abantu, angisangikhulumi la, ngisiza abantu la. Ngiyangizwa bazalwane. Ngisiza wena. Ngisiza nawe wena wena baba. Look at this woman. She is so kind. Uyangithola. She cooks. Uyangithola unakekela abantwana. Umuzi muhle. She's also a businesswoman. She goes an extra mile. Uyangithola bazalwane. Kodwa kunalento eyi-1 ngesinye isikhathi uma ubuya uthi ufuna ezinye izinto athi kajeko hanike khathesi uthi uyabona ke lo mfazi uyabona ungincisha izinto ngento eyi-1 nje manje sokuthi akusiyena umfazi ngento eyi-1 ngoba umntana abantu uzokhathele namhlanje. Ugcina manje ungene uyabona unale basadi babangata uwa ready umphambo wokondle tsamaya uhloshwa hamba you will die, you will die. Don't expect everything from one woman. Oshatangane ngilosi la. Hayi bazana ngizama ukunisiza because our expectations are too high. And they are too high. Now you are sitting here and you are listening to Pastor Mathebula. Now you expect your husband to act like Pastor Mathebula. Indoda yakakusiyena umathebula akakwazi ukushumayela futhi is not gifted ukushumayela. Yekela le ndoda yakho ungayifaki ku pressure, muyekele njalo uma kwenzela igarden ayenza. He is a good man. He is good enough for you. Don't compare him with anybody. Don't compare your wife and then with my wife. Your wife is unique. God has given her some things. Appreciate her. Ngale ndlela engayo. Ungathandaza ufast owenze zonke izinto. Your wife will never, my wife will never be a yellow bone. Ngayenza anyeke azabe yellow anyeke. Uyangithola. Uqale uyo bleach nje ngiyakutshela. Ngalingo bleach. I don't know. You know, sometimes I go back home, but I was saying, but all that I'm saying, Mazalon, don't seek all qualities in one individual. The truth of the matter, God will never give you everything. Because if you're going to have the qualities now, you have become God. If your wife or your husband has all the qualities, you are perfect. So that means now you are at the level of God. You will never. I don't care. Ngithi mina kuwe angaba muhle umntana abantu but abe muhle but yele bone abe nazo zonke izinto akhuluma isilungu esihamba mangambheka kahle. Observe kahle lo muntu lona bathi uthi hamba kuphela, hamba phela. Uthi makubona nomfaka iheel. Kodwa yena muhle. UNkulunkulu ukuncintshe into eyi-1 nje. Akuncintshe nje into eyi-1. Niyangizwa bazalwane? Ube nazo zonke izinto zibe buhle ube nefiga ume ube that tall everything ibe ihlangene yonke into uthi mathula uyabheka hairline kuhaba hairline kuhaba hairline uyangithola hairline God has a way of humbling us, all of us. Anyeka kunikeze zonke izinto uNkulunkulu uzokuncintsha A1. Akuncintshe A1. One thing. Uthi uyashumayela, ushumayele, kuvele nje inoun ikubalekele, ungazi uvele ufake iverb. UNkulunkulu uyakuhambulisha. Be stable and steady in your moods. I can't believe I've even finished my time. Be stable and steady in your moods. Very, very important. Moody people do not attract friends. Being friendly helps you get along with others. This is Bible. Whatever happens, conduct yourself in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ. You see, church is not about information, but relationships. Family is not about information, but relationships. Let us learn, bazalwane, even nakuma families wethu, ukuthi unalo uhlanya labo asibabekezeleleni, you know, and bring them, you know, along the side. And number 7, forgive and move on. We need to forgive and move on. Forgiveness frees us from guilt and allows us to interact positively with other people. The Bible says, bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Ningizwile abantu benkosi. Very important. As the family of God, sizolimazana. As the family, your brothers and sisters, nizolimazana. You understand? And then in your company, you'll have differences. You know, wherever you go, differences will be there. But that doesn't mean we cannot get along and play our music to produce a beautiful music. Accept other people and accept them. Understand that they are not you and then you are not them. But you are able to accommodate, you know, one another to a certain level so that we can achieve this wonderful goal. Niyangizwa bazalwane. Yes, siyahamba siyovota. We are encouraging you. Go uyovota and pray about it. Vote right. But it is very important for us to send a message even to South Africa to say, hey, 29, after the 29th of May, there will be few people who wins and others will never win. Sometimes we win a party on my phone. But it is very important for you to accept ama results in your favor. Because not everything's going to be on your side all the time. So we need to, if we can live with that thing, let me tell you, you will have a wonderful life empilweni. Sengivala ngifuna ukunikeza nje illustration bazalwane. You know ngiyanikhulekela futhi kanini nina enshadile. We know that imshado yamanje inama challenges. You know, even before you get married, especially as a business person, you need to calculate. I remember when I was marrying this couple, I said to Mama Tebula, ngicela senishadise nabanye, angisafuna ukushadisa ngoba ngiyalimala, abanye abantu abakwazi ukukhuluma. You know, God might have blessed you with things, but don't get into a counseling room and then you throw those things first and say, mfundisi, before ngikhuluma, ngifuna nje kuba clear ukuthi kunezinto engiachievile ezami akuse zakhe. I mean, I was never offended like this. I mean, this woman, she's seated there, and then this guy says, say in a contract, nothing wrong, because it is very important. You need to protect the business. If anything goes wrong, but the business is protected. But I also realized that sometimes the devil is using that, you know, to attack imshado yetu. Young talk. So, mfundisi uthini? Hey, mina ngisizile bazalwane. Le ye in community. Ingisizile ngoba kunesikhathi lapha ngithi hey ngiyayeka lento hey ngicabange uyo yo ngiyophuma kanjani ubani uthatha lento. I hope restoration in a so divide agachan. Ungenzam. Asale ni kuna nanga. So it's working on my own advantage. So choose my keten. Kota sometimes for nungene wezi nyizindo. I commitment ibe serious. Protect what is yours. Protect yourself. Don't allow your achievements. Zingene kanda. Zigwenze ukulume ngenyindlela. Don't allow your achievements to make you to look at another person abo umuntu ongathi akana value. Never allow those things. These are just material things. They are just material things. Zibeke endaweni yazo. And then noma sokuba nokuqabana, you understand? Don't attack the relationship. Lezi zinto mazinga affect i relationship. Uyangithola bazalwane. Very, very, very important. And this is how you get along. Ukuthi wena you are playing this part of a band, it does not make you much better than me. We might be different, but we are all equal. Let me take a minute and give you the 10 commandments for getting along. Number one, how do you get along? 10 commandments, you need to speak to people. There is nothing as nice as cheerful word of greetings. You know, ngene ndaweni bese uyabingelela bazalwane. Ungengene ndaweni uthola abantu bayikhona uthule ungabingelelanga. Dumedisa bathu ungamani uthule. It is not African. This is not Europe. Is an African. Get in the one more tall abantu bahlezi, fundisana abantu anabako. Yes, good morning, sir. Good morning, ma'am. I tati luto, lento le, ungangeni jenda wenu velutule, bingelela bantu, intente le wienza. People will love you. People will give you ama titles. Just ngokubingelela. You can even get a business because ama menas wako, they go a long way. Number two, smile at people. It takes 72 muscles to frown and only 14 to smile. Abanye benishwabene, hayi ukuthi nigugile. It is because you are always angry. Uhlala u. Maku smile, when you smile, there are juices that are released in your face. You will shine, you will look beautiful. Ngokuhleka nje, ngokuhleka. Ngiyangithola bazalwane. So people, they love people who are friendly. Number three, call people by their name. Abantu bayathanda ukubizwa ngamagama wabo. Learn their names. Number four, be friendly and helpful. You know, if you want to have friends, be friendly. Number five, be cordial. Speak and act pleasantly at all time. Kuluma nabantu kahle, ungabi rough ngasonke isikhathi. Learn to speak well with people. Labantu baba make sure they will hear you when you speak to them nicely. Number six, be genuinely interested in people. You can find something interesting about every person. Makubiza abantu, how's your life? How was your day yesterday? Abantwana bakho banjani na? you know, how's your wife? How's your husband? Are you still keeping well? Is there anything that I can pray for? Well, Masongi's card is all about you. No. And not only that, number seven, be generous with praise. Are you with me? And be cautious with criticism. Ungabulo umuntu ohlale criticize Masongi's card. When a mavulumlomo we are criticized, are you kinto enhle oyibonayo la ekhaya? Uloku uya suspect, suspicious when. Iyaphi imali yakule bandla? Hey, awuyiboni yenzani imali? Nangizobazelwana. So be generous with praise. Be considerate of the feelings of others. Cabanga abanye abantu banama feelings. Be thoughtful of the opinion of others. Be thoughtful. When people give you their opinions, you must always know they are. This is their opinion. Ungalwi to try to bring your opinion all the time ahead. And finally, be alert to give service. Be alert to give service. What you do for others is important. Praise the name of Jesus. We are uniting families. We are uniting the church. As we wrap up this theme, I pray that you will find grace to go back to your family. There's that sheep that we call it a black sheep of the family. Let me tell you, they need us to understand them. They need us to bring them together. This other one who has gone astray, understand them, they're totally different. These young people who think in a different way, understand them. Wafika omunye umama ekhala inyembezi athi nanga umntana ungena usathane usathane ungena ephi mama athi bon abambe isandla athi bon ufaka ithathu uyambona usathane wonke lento usathane trying to help them you know because these things are happening and you might end up losing your children ngoba sobona usathane lana uyangithola and abantwana bethu they challenge us abuye omunye afaka icici lana. What do? You cannot utati bagete long utati inganu lakenange bagete. Because it na ulfagil. Sometimes just pray for them. You are living in a different season. They've got a different view of life. But we must never lose izinto ezibalulekile ngabantwana bethu. Let us try to win them. And some of them, they've been influenced by the world. I mean, as a young person, noma ngimusha mina zanga ngize ngilibeke ibhruku la. The other day, but I realized, and these boys, they love the Lord. But let us learn to be patient, love them, and walk with them in this journey. Is that okay, Bazalwan? All of us, let us submit under the Lordship of Jesus Christ. Would you please stand on your feet this morning? Hallelujah. Do you receive it this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Father, we give you praise. We give you all the glory. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you, Father, for leading us up to this.